How long you been fishing, Jarrett?
Well, Devin, my whole life.
How are they snapping, boys?
Like always.
They're not.
Could be the bait.
I'll take a beer.
I'll have a brat.
Can you believe it? Fish just ain't biting today.
Oh, boys.
Who's that?
Don't look.
Best day ever.
I love fishing. Oh, yeah. I love fishing, yeah.
One trick with your wife. Drink an appropriate amount of that man's life. Drink it for peace or drink it to fight. Drink an appropriate amount of that man's life. Go to bed at 8 or party all night. Drink an appropriate amount of that man's life. Athens life, Athens life. Drink an appropriate amount of Athens life. Enjoy Athens Light at Pizza on the Farm every Friday and Saturday. Stony Acres Brewing, Athens, Wisconsin. Drink an appropriate amount of Athens Light.
Testing 1, 2. Seems like it works. Hey, 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 hey. Oh, oh, oh.
Looking good on your end? Okay. All right. Well, we could get this show on the road if we want to. Are we live on camera? I don't know where that one is. It's this way. Somewhere. Where is that camera? Is it that one? Oh, it's this one. Okay. I forgot there's a camera. Hi, guys. So many cameras, I don't know where to look. Well, welcome to the last show of my Upper Midwest tour of this last couple weeks. Thank you so much for being here in this beautiful barn. This is a good end to the tour, absolutely. And well, my name's Alice Wallace. You already know that. Lately I've been starting with this song, which is a song that's on my brand new record that is not out yet, but I just finished recording and I'm very excited about it. And it's my moving to Nashville song. And I moved to Nashville in December of 2019. Perfect timing, if you want to line it up with like a worldwide pandemic. I had about 3 months before the world shut down right after I moved to Nashville. And so I knew I was going to have to write a moving to Nashville song, but for the first year, I mostly just watched a lot of Netflix and cried and contemplated life. And so it wasn't until like the next summer that I wrote this song, when I was kind of fully coming to, you know, like just realizing I really lived in Nashville. Like, I feel like the first year just didn't really feel like I lived anywhere. You know, like everything was so chaotic. And but it was really sinking in, and I was, you know, realizing this was going to be my life now of the Nashville swampy summers. Coming from California, I got to inherit a few million mosquitoes, and I know you guys know what that's like up here. But right about in June, when the fireflies came out, I was like, okay, if I have to get used to mosquitoes to get fireflies, I think I can handle this. So the song's called Fireflies. Something in the way the air hangs heavy and wraps you in a blanket every time you step outside. They say mosquitoes like you if you're sweet, so I pretend that I'm not sweet. Still they eat me alive. But it's so, so green here in Tennessee on a nearly summer night in early June. California, I think of you all the time, but I don't know that I'll be back anytime soon. Because it feels like home now when the fireflies come out. The nights are warmer than you'd think, but as the sun begins to sink, you hear the evening melody. And then a thousand little stars leap and dance in the backyard to a cicada symphony. But it's so, so green here in Tennessee, and my birthday's getting close in late July. California, I think of you all the time, and you know that it was hard to say goodbye. But it feels like home now when the fireflies come out.
some of this lightning in a bottle, see if I can make it last. But it's so, so green here in Tennessee. Even when the summer nights start turning cold, California, I think of you all the time, and I'll come back now and then to say hello, 'cause it feels like home now. When the fireflies come out, well, thank you so much. Feels great in here. Well, so I mentioned California, moved to Nashville from California, and my last solo record was very much inspired by things in California. And this next one is something, it's a song that I wrote with a friend of mine named Andrew Delaney about a phenomenon we have out in Southern California called the Santa Ana Winds. I don't know if any of you guys have ever been out there when the Santa Anas roll through, but it's usually about October, and there are these hot, dry winds that blow in off the desert across the Southland, and everything gets very eerie, and when it kind of feels like everything is still, even though the wind is howling. And and nowadays, when the Santa Anas roll through, the first thing on everyone's mind are the wildfires, because it's just the slightest little spark, and things are just so dry and staticky. So I wrote this song a few years back with my friend Andrew when we were watching what was then the worst wildfire California had ever seen. It was called the Thomas Fire, and it was in like Santa Barbara and Ventura counties. And I feel like that's kind of when things started to turn a corner, and everything got just so much more serious when it came to the fires out there. And like we were chatting before the show, I mean, just sort of natural disasters in general now just ramp up every single year, and we're just kind of trying to hang on to the planet. And especially in California, what struck me was that, you know, a lot of times the people living on top of the hill might have a lot more than the people living at the bottom of the hill, but when the fires come through, it doesn't matter how much money you have or where you live. Those Santa Ana winds are just gonna blow. So this is called the Santa Ana Winds. Out on the horizon, there's a wicked orange glow, while a neighbor sprays a rooftop with a garden hose. You heard they couldn't save the horses, so they had to let them go, while the Santa Ana winds just blow. The newsman, he keeps talking like he thinks that you don't know, and the shelters, they're all stocked up with prayers and with hopes. And it's get out now and on your way with whatever you can hold, while the Santa Ana winds just blow. We come from dust and ashes, and to such we may return. Light a candle to St. Barbara and watch it burn. Oh. Oh, 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 oh. Now the helicopter's leaving, turning eddies in the smoke. and it's hot and thick and black, and it's hanging in your throat. The flames that lick your neighborhood eat you out of house and home. All the center and winds just blow. We come from dust and ashes, and to such we may return. Light a candle to save mother and watch it burn. Ooh. Song I want to share with you that I wrote with a friend of mine in Nashville. And I gotta say, you know, it wasn't until I started visiting Nashville and then moved to Nashville that I really got used to the co-writing thing, like writing songs with other songwriters. It's huge in Nashville. Everybody co-writes all the time. And I feel like a lot of times I say it's like the Nashville handshake. You meet a songwriter and you're like, hey, you want to write a song? Like, it's a great way to kind of get to know people. And I like to, a lot of times I liken it to like an awkward first date, because a lot of times it's people you barely know, you know, you get together, you chit chat for like an hour trying to see if you have anything in common, and sometimes you don't really, and you write a terrible song and you're like, I will never see you again. But and then sometimes you write an amazing song, and it's a really interesting experience. And like, I feel like even if you don't write a great song, you just learn something about how that person writes a song. And it's just like, it's really interesting to get two creative people in the room and just see what happens. And this song I wrote with a friend, although she wasn't really a friend when we got together. Like, I had met her once and I did the whole, hey, you want to write a song? And she said, okay. And her name is Crystal Bauer Socks. And fantastic singer and songwriter, has a very Janis Joplin-y, like belty voice. And she was on the third season of American Idol. You might recognize her name. Way back when, at least I used to still watch it. And so we got together and we were chatting, trying to figure out what we could write a song about. And in our chatting, we came to the realization that in our travels, because we both tour a lot, spend a lot of time on the road, that we had both fallen in love with two-steppin' cowboys along the way. Mine was in Texas. I think hers was like in Montana or something. But we had both fallen victim to the cowboy who can dance, which is just like a lethal combination. And it never ends well. So we wrote this song called When This Song Ends. He was a looker with a damn fine two-step. No cream, no sugar, a man of simple taste, but a hard nut to crack. He may not be what she needs, but a three-minute song could change everything. Music plays, he takes her hand. They twirl and sway like waves on sand. It's the only way he'll ever let a woman close. There's no time to think about what comes next or where they'll be when this song ends. She's always been the kind to take it slow. But wherever he leads, she'll go. She wasn't looking to find a fabled man, and she's been broken by every charming face that took hers in his hands. The dance, the mood, the man, they've all been wrong. She only knows the steps when she's in his arms. And the music plays, he takes her hand. They twirl and sway like waves on sand. It's the only way he'll ever let a woman close. There's no time to think about what comes next or where they'll be when this song ends. She's always been the kind to take it slow. But wherever he leads, she'll go. If she takes the chance, she might get hurt. This dance could be their last or their first. And the music plays, he takes her hand. They twirl and sway like waves on sand. It's the only way he'll ever let a woman close. About what comes next or where they'll be when this song ends. She's always been the kind to take it slow. But wherever he leads, she'll have to close her eyes and trust her feet. Wherever he leads, she'll go. Well, thank you so much. Are you guys two-steppers? What'd you say? Did you say bad stepping? Oh, one stepper. I mean, hey, you can do as many steps as you want, you know? All right. Well, we're going to take a little trip to northern Arizona with this next song. I wrote this song about a little town called Jerome, Arizona. Have you guys been to Jerome?
I love Jerome.
Isn't Jerome amazing? It is. It's kind of magical. And on one of my very first tours I ever took, I was living in Southern California, and I wanted to start touring, and I had no idea how or where to go or how to do anything. And so I started asking other songwriter friends, like, where should I go on tour? And someone told me to go to Jerome, Arizona. And I'm still not exactly sure why, because it was 7 hours away and the gig paid like $50. You know, it wasn't really a very good financial decision. But as soon as I pulled into town, I was like, oh, man, like, what is this place? And I need to write a song about it. So I started doing a little research. And so Jerome it's known as a ghost town now, but it's an old west like copper mining town. It was built around this copper mine. They found copper in this mountain, built a town just kind of zigzagging along this hill around it so the miners would have a place to live. But then it has like this really dark and interesting history. One of the things I was most fascinated by were these sulfur deposits in the mines kept catching fire. And one time the fires were burning in these mines for 20 years underground. And I had never heard of a fire burning for 20 years. So I was like, there's something about a song in there, right? And also, you know, it's a very dangerous town. When you walk into the little history museum, one of the things it says on the wall is like this, like, you know, headline from like the New York Sun around the turn of the century calling Jerome the wickedest town in the West. And so, yeah, these mines were very dangerous. And in order to kind of keep the miners, you know, somewhat placated in their dangerous occupation, they just made sure there were plenty of opium dens and brothels to keep them entertained. And so I started thinking about these brothels in town, because apparently at any given time in a town of like 300 people, there were 20 brothels. And it's like, wow, what must have been like to be a woman in old Jerome? So started thinking, turning that over in my head. And then I found out that Jerome is on Cleopatra Hill. So I was like, well, Jerome basically is a woman. So I had to write a song portraying Jerome as a woman. Her name is Cleopatra, and she has a fire that they can't put out. Poor Cleopatra, she sits and waits for the men who will come over calling again. And each time they call, well, her hatred, it grows and burns like a fire that only she knows. Well, they can't put it out. They can't put it out. Once she was young and so pretty, a girl too pretty, they told her, irresistible. Though she was young, what she had was so rare that the risk of getting burned wouldn't stop those who dared. And now they can't put it out. They can't put it out. It wasn't long before rumors had spread of the treasures that lay waiting to be claimed in her bed. Once there was one, there were hundreds of men lined up to stoke the fires that burned beneath her skin. And now they can't put it out. They can't put it out. No, they can't put it out. I can't put it out. Oh, Cleopatra. Oh, well, 20 years is far too long to burn. They found they were no match when the flames grew too strong. Poor Cleopatra still sits there and bleeds, her heart charred black by the fires of greed. And now they can't put it out, no. Those of you who haven't been to Jerome, you're going to have to put it on your list now. You got to go to Jerome. Really fascinating place. And take the history tour and learn about how terrible of a place it was. I mean, one of the craziest stories is that, you know, all these miners were losing their lives in the mines, and, you know, instead, you know, so the wives, and they tried to sort of strike to try to be like, we need safer conditions. And instead of really giving them safer conditions, he's like, well, the guy, you know, like the sort of tycoon who owned the mines, said, well, okay, we're not going to give you safer conditions, but we will give you death benefits. Basically, we will throw you in the smelter that separates the copper and like the, you know, like the black stuff. I can't remember what that stuff's called. And so, you know, like basically, and then they used that stuff to pave the streets of Jerome. So basically, the streets of Jerome are paved with the miners. So, you know, all these really good reasons to go, I'm telling you. But it's just like a place like no other. They're like, oh, and, you know, in this saloon, you know, Billy the Kid and Wyatt Earp, like, had a showdown, you know, it's so good. It's just this little slice of history, of terrible history, basically. So, on that note, maybe I shouldn't tell that story in shows. Maybe it is not. Maybe people don't want to know that. It's so fascinating to me, though. okay, so I'm going to do a song that I did not write in this next one. But this is one of my favorite songs in the whole world. And it became really special to me a few years ago. I got to be part of this show in Los Angeles where, for one night only, they brought back this club called the Palomino Club. And so for about 50 years, the Palomino Club was the home of country music in Los Angeles. It was in North Hollywood. It was open from the 50s to the 90s. And anybody who was anybody played there, from Patsy Cline to Dwight Yoakam. Like, any country music, you know, singer would always play the Palomino Club. And so just the stories that came out of this place were amazing. And I never got to go. It closed before I even got to L.A., but the women who run the record label that I'm on were part of this team that brought it back for one night because they found out that the building was still standing and you could rent it as an event space. And so they rented it for the night. They redecorated it just like it was the Palomino Club, put the stage back in. They found the original sign in this like old LA History Museum, and they like hung the original sign again. And so it had a bunch of people like Jim Lauderdale and Rosie Flores and James Intfeld, who like got their start at the Palomino Club, played that night. And a few of us up-and-comers also got to play. But the stipulation was I had to sing a song that was sung by an artist who had played at the Palomino Club when it was open. And the list is huge. It was not that hard to pick. But at the same time, you know, one glance at the list and I was like, well, of course I have to do a Linda Ronstadt song. And this is my favorite Linda Ronstadt song. And I love that, you know, that night I had to, I got to be backed up by a group of musicians who had all played at the Palomino when it was open. Like, they were members of the house band. And the guitar player, one of the guitar players in the band, came up to me before the show and he's like, you know, I heard Linda sing this song on that stage back in the 70s. He's like, but, you know, the bar owner was not happy at all, actually, because they didn't sell a single drink her whole set. And I was like, now I'm even more nervous. Here we go. But it was so amazing, and I've been singing this song almost every night since. This is called Long, Long Time. Love will abide. Take things in stride. Sounds like good advice, but there's no one at my side. And time washes clean love's wounds unseen. That's what someone told me, but I don't know what it means. 'Cause I've done everything I know to try and make you mine. And I think I'm gonna love you for a long, long time. Caught in my fears, blinking back the tears. I can't say you hurt me when you never let me near, and I never drew one response from you. All the while you fell all over girls you never knew, 'cause I've done everything I know to try and make you mine. And I think it's gonna hurt me for a long, long time. Wait for the day you'll go away, knowing that you warned me of the price I'd have to pay. And life's full of flaws, who knows the cause? Living in a memory of a love. Everything I know to try and change your mind. And I think I'm gonna miss you for a long, long time. Yes, I've done everything I know to try. I think I'm gonna love you for a long, long time. Thank you so much. Rise. Back to one of my songs here. This is a song I wrote about my first time on the back of a motorcycle. Although, of course, really it's about the boy who was driving the motorcycle. It's called Motorcycle Ride. The coffee shop was empty, except a table by the door. A 10-minute conversation, we're not strangers anymore. I knew what I would answer before he even asked. Something about the way he held his shoulders when he laughed. Small talk in the suburbs to fly in 80 on the 10. Just me and him and a Moto Guzzi bike between our legs. The interstate gave way to the winding mountain road. I leaned into the curves as if I knew how this should go. But I've always been the girl to hang back and play it safe. So afraid of getting hurt by the risks I
never take. But I learned two things that night. Don't hang on too tight and always take that motorcycle ride. Ooh. Well, the mountain air was sweet, and I sipped it in like wine. His cabin smelled of redwood and linseed oil and thyme. I steadied on his arm, still feeling the bike move after holding on so hard to everything I had to prove. We drifted around in circles on the lake all afternoon. Stories of our lives and loves and phases of the moon. I couldn't tell you whether it was waxing or it waned, but it moves so slow and slight that I never see it change. But I've always been a girl to hang back and play it safe. So afraid of getting hurt by the risks I never take. But I learned two things that night. Don't hang on too tight and always take that motorcycle ride. Some people cross your path and you know they'll always stay. Others fly you up a mountain and they're gone the way they came. But that day up at the cabin, that night spent in the pines, well, that boy and his bike are ever gentle on my mind. Cause I've always been the girl to hang back and play it safe. So afraid of getting hurt by the risks I never take. But I learned two things that night. Don't hang on too tight and always take that motorcycle ride.
For a sip of water. Cheers. Okay, so we have entered a very special portion of the evening. I think it's about time we did a yodel. I don't know if you guys were prepared for the fact that you were coming to a show in which yodeling would be involved. Were you warned? Okay. Probably most people. And you came anyway. Look at that. You guys are brave people. I know. I feel like there's just not enough yodeling going on in the world these days, and I'm trying to bring it back. And it is an uphill battle, I will tell you that. But it's fine. You know, I'm up for the challenge. We're slowly but surely making progress, converting people one show at a time into realizing they liked yodeling. Was that the first yodel at Pirates? Probably. I know. A lot of times I think I am the first yodeler in many spaces. Yes. Because there's not that many of us still doing it. So, you know, it's just... So those of us who do, we gotta make sure we do it. The first and the last. Until I come back. You know, the first for now. And hopefully not last. I know. Well, Scott's like, never mind. Not doing this again. The whole band? Okay, let's see if we can get the whole band up here. Let's do it. Would be super fun. Okay, so this is a yodel written and performed by the great Don Walser, who was a famous Texas yodeler. They called him the Pavarotti of the Plains. And I've heard the yodel in this song referred to as a turkey gobble yodel. So if you listen closely, you won't miss it. Yeah, it's pretty obvious. So it's called the Rolling Stone from Texas.
I'm a rolling stone from Texas, a rolling stone from the plains. I'm a rolling stone from Texas, boys, and I long to be back there again. Say, are you from Texas? Well, that's what I'm wanting to know. 'Cause if we're both from Texas, boys, let's bundle up our clothes and go.
Turkey goblin for you.
They say a rolling stone never gathers no mosses, long as it's rolling along. I don't care if I gather any moss if it's in my Texas home. And I've got a little girl awaiting, and her name is Patricia Jane. And I'll never be happy till I'm by her side, those West Texas plains.
Turkey gobble got a little tangled there in the middle, but it's fine. We recovered.
Okay.
Woo! We having fun yet, guys?
Yeah.
Now the party has started. Now.
All right.
So. I know. So usually I do that at the end of a set. You know, that way I can just like go lie down afterwards. But it's fine. We're good. We're gonna keep. We're powering on. So I thought I'd do this song. So during the pandemic, my friend Caitlin Cannon and I started a band because, you know, there was nothing to do but just kind of like stay home and write songs and hope that one day you got to play them for people again. And so she and I got on like a Zoom call like every Wednesday and we started writing songs. And like after like the first summer of 2020, like we just... We had like a whole album's worth of songs and we decided to put them out on a CD. And I brought some along with me. And this was one of the first songs we wrote, which was inspired by the situation we were all in. We were trying to just find ways to kind of get through this very strange time. And we were like, maybe in all of this terribleness, there's some sort of silver lining that we just have to look for, you know? Like, maybe we all just needed a collective break from our lives for a minute. And so we wrote this song and ended up being the title track of our record. It's called Lucky Break.
Mm-hmm. Well, all the races have been called off. All the clocks have been stopped. Every contest is awash. And all the meetings are postponed. All the outcomes are unknown. And everyone's alone. Nobody's getting ahead. Nobody's missing out. We're no better than anyone else. Right here in the right now. Have you ever prayed for your whole life to change? Well, this could be your lucky break. Well, all the wheels falling off, the sky fell and the ground opened up, but it couldn't swallow all of us. Don't know when the dust will clear, but what's a few months or years to fix what's really broken here? Nobody's getting ahead, nobody's missing out. We're no better than right here in the right now. Have you ever prayed for your whole life to change? Well, this could be your lucky break. No one asked if you were ready to let go, but if you aim for rock bottom, maybe you'll strike gold. While nobody's getting ahead, nobody's missing out. We're no better than anyone else right here in the right now. Have you ever prayed for the whole world to change? Well, this could be your lucky break. Hey. Hey.
Thanks so much. And I want to play one, well, I think it's one more new song, not one more song. But this is a song that's going on my new record that I just finished recording a couple months ago. It's not going to come out till next year, but this is the last song I wrote for that record, and I wrote it about my anxiety about going into the studio to record my new record. Suddenly I had a new song, because this is the first time I've ever recorded a record the Nashville way, which basically involves hiring this like ridiculously talented band of like Grammy-winning musicians. You go in the studio for 2 days, you record the whole album in 2 days, and they don't even want to hear the songs first. Because they're like, that's when the magic happens. We all just get in the room together, and we go 1, 2, 3, go, and we make a song. So that we don't all come in with different ideas, and we have to like fight over like, oh, what if we did this lick here and this lick here? It's like, no, let's just make it all together. Which does sound like magic, and also sounds terrifying. And I was like, okay. So I was just like having these panic attacks leading up to going into the studio. And, you know, as a songwriter, I channeled all that anxiety into a song. And this isn't really about my anxiety, but it is about that feeling that I'm hoping some of you can relate to, of, you know, waking up in the morning oftentimes and thinking, you know, one of these days, people are going to discover I have no idea what I'm doing. That I'm just making this stuff up as I go along. And I'm a total fraud. So that's what this song is about. That feeling. It's called Imposter.
It's Someday someone's gonna find out my biggest secret. I know they will. It's just a matter of time. You can look right at me and never even see it. 'Cause I've perfected the art of seeming fine, even when I'm not. Someday someone's gonna figure out what I've been hiding. I know they will. 'Cause I can't keep a straight face, and still no one will ever say I wasn't trying. I've worked damn hard for this epic fall from grace, just like I was taught. True, sure the sky might fall and the truth might turn to doubt, but it's time someone found me out. Someday someone's gonna realize I'm an imposter. I know they will. It's just a question of when they'll shake their heads and say, well, this is gonna cost her. They won't understand why I risked it all just to pretend that I was someone else. Someday someone's gonna figure out that I've been faking. I know they will. 'Cause I can't keep this up, and I'm the one whose heart I have been breaking. Who'd have thought that I was worthy of love? My worst fears come true. Sure, the sky might fall and the truth might turn to doubt, but it's time someone found me out. Very much. All right. Well, now back to some classic Alice Wallace songs. And this is one that is on my last record, and I wrote it one afternoon when I had some free time. I was like, I should write a song. I'm a songwriter. That's what I do. And sometimes you can't write a good song, even though you're a songwriter. Actually, a lot of times when you're a songwriter, you can't write a good song. And that day, I just felt like all of my ideas were terrible. And so I just kept throwing out ideas a couple hours. And I was about to give up. I was like, maybe it's just not in the cards today. And then this thought popped into my head. I was like, well, maybe if I have nothing new to say today, I just need to find a new way to sing the same old song. So then I wrote this one called The Same Old Song. I need a moment, a reason, a rhyme. Feels like I've lost a little piece of my mind. Oh, and I've been searching my whole life long, trying to find a new way to sing the same old song. We all have our moments when everything's clear. trying to find a new way to sing the same old song. Now don't you try.
Okay. I want to do one more cover song before I do my last few Alice Wallace songs for you. And this is a song, another song by one of my idols, a different idol, Patty Griffin. Are you guys familiar with Patty Griffin? Okay, fantastic. I think she's one of the, you know, the great songwriters of our time. And to me, this is my favorite song of hers. And it's not as famous of a song. It was on her record called An American Kid that she wrote a lot about her dad passing away. And there's just something about this song that I think the metaphor in this song is just perfect. It's called Wild Old Dog.
I love this.
I'm glad you know it.
Someone left out on the highway. I've seen him running by me. He don't belong to no one now. dropped him out on 93. A mange was setting in on his hips and on his knees. Between the highways running north and south, we pulled on over and we put him out. Willie said he was old and going blind, and Mama told me how she didn't mind. And when Willie kicked him with his shoe, he just climbed on in, just like he knew. Someone left out on the highway. I've seen him running by me. He don't belong to no one now. It's lonely on the highway. Sometimes the heart gets turned to dust, gets whittled down to nothing, broken down and crushed in with the bones of wild old dogs, wild old dogs. We dropped him out on 93. Tall grass was waving there just like the sea. He tore off running like we'd set him free, and just disappeared right in front of me.
A good song. I almost put that on my album, but then I decided I didn't have enough money and I would have had to cut one of my own songs. I was like, okay, I'm just gonna start playing it at my shows all the time because I love that song so much. So I'm gonna go back a few years for this song, and this is on an album I have with me, and this is another song about being on the road. And I wrote this kind of early on in my touring career, after my very first trip through Texas. Back in the days where I was like, well, I know one person in San Antonio and one person in Dallas, so I'll just go play in those two places, and at least I'll know there's one person in each of those places that's gonna come to the show. And I ended up taking a mega bus between San Antonio and Dallas because it was only $9. And those were early days when I wasn't sure I'd made the right decision to quit my job and start playing music full time. But on that megabus ride, I sat next to this young girl, and we had this amazing conversation that was just so inspiring and grounding and just really helped me to realize in that moment, like, what a, you know, it just, it really is such a joy just to get to be able to travel, even if you're on a mega bus, to get to have a conversation with an inspiring stranger and, you know, learn something. And so I got home and I decided to put her in a song. Although I also put in a mention about the man who sat next to me on my flight home from Dallas. Another fellow traveler who was also very memorable, but for very different reasons. So this is called A Traveling Song. Well, I'll sing you a traveling song, a song about searching, about moving along. I may not be rich, may never well be, but in all of my travels, I've got what I need. Well, I met a young girl on the way to Austin on a bus ride one mid-April day. She asked me about the guitar in my hand. I told her about all the shows I had planned. She told me that she was 18, and for the last 7 weeks, how she'd been living by the Mexican border after a flood, rebuilding homes in the mold and the mud for folks who were living with less than most of us could ever fathom, I'd guess. And she had only a pillow and a small bag of clothes. She'd been on 3 buses since before the sun rose. Oh, how inspired I was by someone so young who would give up so much to help all those people who could never help her, spending her time just to better this world. Oh, I'll sing you a traveling song, a song about kindness, about righting a wrong. I may not be brave, may never well be, but I hope I can learn from the people I meet. Now flying home from that very same trip, on a flight out of Dallas, I had the pleasure to sit by a man who was not at all pleased to be stuck back in coach with a person like me. When a mother came on with a child, he rolled his eyes at her and sighed when she smiled, and I was stuck in the middle for that 3-hour ride with his elbow periodically digging my side. He got mad later on in the flight when the attendant did not have the bourbon he liked. Oh, I just closed my eyes, thought back to that bus, wondering where that young girl I met was. I've met all kinds of folks on the road, those who are wise and those who don't know. The only true thing that we have in this life is a chance to wake up in the new morning light. Oh, I'll sing you a traveling song, a song about peace, about not hanging on. I may not be rich, may never wear
travels, I've got what I need. In all of my travels, I've got what I need. In all of my travels, I've got what I need. Thank you so much, you guys. I got just a couple more songs for you. And this one is a song that was the title track off my last record, and it's a song about chasing after your dreams, which I finally decided to do about, I think, 11 or 12 years ago. I need to go back and add up the years now, and now it's all kind of running together. But, you know, I tried for a long time to do anything other than music, even though this is all I wanted to do once I picked up a guitar when I was like 15 years old and started writing songs. But I was like, that's not a job, you know. So it took me a long time to get up the guts to quit my job and just start doing this and figuring it out along the way. And when I wrote this song, I was living in Southern California, and I was thinking about my musical dreams as being like this little speck out on the horizon in the Pacific Ocean that I just had to sail off after, not really knowing what kind of tsunamis and hurricanes were going to be waiting for me out there on the water, but I just had to do it anyway. And and luckily also my parents let me move back home with them for a while, so that's cool. So I wrote this song. It's called The Blue. It goes like this. Sail away into the blue. It's out there waiting. It could be waiting for you. You're only scared of the things that you can't see. Most beautiful things you only see in your dreams. It's all a mystery, an untold story, a blank page waiting for a line, a metronome just marking time. And now you stand right at the edge of where you'll go and where you've been. The only certainty is you and the blue. And the blue. Sail away till you can't see. Or the person you used to be. A place where you can't hear what they all say. Oh, and all the pain and the shame of the world fall away. Oh,
blue. And the blue.
Well, thank you guys so very much. This is going to be my last song. I know.
Wait, kiss.
I'm sorry I didn't brush up on my Kiss songs before tonight. I really should have. I know you guys are missing out on seeing Kiss tonight to come see me. So I really appreciate you choosing me over Kiss. That's a big big compliment. I really appreciate it. And if anybody's tuning in out there, thank you for watching. This has been so lovely. Well, I don't have any Kiss for you, but I do have more yodeling. Yeah. So, I mean, I feel like those things are pretty comparable, right? You know? And this is always my grand finale. I always like introduce it as my grand finale / encore, because there's really nothing I can do after this to like top this. So it has to be like the encore that you didn't ask for also. So this is my song that I wrote about teaching myself how to yodel. So it's kind of a yodeling lesson if you listen closely and feel like joining in at any point, you know? I know. Maybe you haven't had enough wine yet, but if you feel the urge, I know. Where's Elton when you need him? He would have yodeled along. What's that? He probably is yodeling in there. Yes, he probably is. Okay. Well, here's your big grand finale. Thank you guys so much for being here. Thanks for hosting, Scott. And this wonderful Bertsch barn. This is called A Little Yodel. Well, in case you haven't heard, I like to sing a little now and then. Then one day my world was to change. I heard a voice sing loud and clear like I had never heard, and I knew that I wanted to sing that way. I sang that song so many times it was kind of absurd, but I had to glue those sounds into my head. And I'm sure I drove my friends insane with my incessant practicing as I sang these words over and now once I got the basics down, the lows, the lows, the lees, well, everything just fell right into place. Voice figured out what to do, skip through the notes with ease as my fingers on the strings keep the faith. The basics. You guys just got to go home and practice, and next time we can all yodel together, right? Piece of cake. It's going to happen next time. Actually, I would bet Scott's going to learn how to yodel by the time I get back here. He's going to do it. Well, now pretty soon all that just got too easy for me, and I had to push myself for something more. And the only way that I could think to make it any harder was just to go faster than before. Thank you guys so much for being here. I had a lovely time. I do CDs for sale in case you still have a working CD player. And if not, you know, you could just throw them at things or something. I don't know. Thank you so much, Scott. Can't wait to see you guys next time.